Stroke is a syndrome caused by a disturbance in the blood circulation of the brain which compromises its function. It is the second leading cause of death in the world, and occurs predominantly in middle-aged and elderly adults. There were more than 25 million stroke survivors worldwide, and this population is predicted to reach 70 million by 2030. Generally, after a stroke, people need to deal with the various consequences, such as motor, sensory or cognitive changes. And the most effective recovery occurs in the first 3 months, with great efficiency of neuroplasticity in the first month. Humans use both hands together most of the time, and the loss of the function of either hand requires major adjustments to our interactions with the physical world. A common response to this loss after a stroke is to learn compensatory ways of movement, including using the non-paretic hand. There are also compensatory changes in the coordination of movements of both hands and of the paretic forearm with the trunk. The widely used method for quantitative analysis of movements is the study based on musculoskeletal models. These models provide a framework for anatomical and physiological data integration, allowing a wide range of studies in neuromuscular control based on biomechanics. Upper limb models, for example, have been used as a way to better understand neuromuscular control in the rehabilitation of patients after a stroke. Several technologies help with rehabilitation. Serious games and virtual reality are some of the rehabilitation technologies that are most effective in gaining functional capacity. Interventions in a virtual environment promote neuroplasticity by providing task-oriented training with high repetition rates and parameter adjustments, such as therapy time, intensity, and challenges. Rehabilitation using virtual environments enhances brain plasticity when associated with motor, sensory, and visual stimuli. Intended actions through motor goals and visual feedback result in an increased rate of patient recovery. A virtual environment will enable individuals to carry out specific therapeutic activities in a pleasant and motivating way, allowing more repetitions and contributing to increased rehabilitation intensity. This project is about an integrated system to assist in the proprioceptive and motor rehabilitation of patients with hemiparesis in the upper limbs resulting from a stroke. The system is composed of a virtual environment and a highly customizable robotic device, which will allow the therapist to adjust the rehabilitation procedures according to the patient's clinical evolution. During the training sessions, the patient interacts with a force platform by moving its manipulator. The positions captured by the platform are sent in real time to the game and converted to the harpy's movement. The game can also act on the platform through motor feedback, providing the patient a better feeling of control over the harpy. In addition, it is intended to map the musculoskeletal activity of the affected limb through a three-dimensional model. This model will detect biomechanical variations to provide motor feedback that can be used for analysis and correction of compensatory movements during training sessions. A network of inertial sensors positioned on the hemiparetic limb will also be implemented to capture and calculate anatomical changes and movement dynamics of the shoulder and elbow. Thus, it is intended to evaluate the adequacy of the system, developed as a support tool in the rehabilitation processes, and to help the therapist to define more specific rehabilitation protocols for each individual. The virtual environment is composed of a forest, where the patient controls a harpy, moving in different directions depending on the goals and challenges to be accomplished. Initially, three levels were developed, and an interactive tutorial. The animals were modeled and textured based on real high-resolution photos. And the environment is modeled with a high level of realism, which is important for motivation and engagement. In the first level, the patient must go through several rings spread across the scene. It is necessary to make smooth and solid movements with the arm. In level 2, the patient must catch 5 fish in the lake. The capture must be quick and accurate, working with flexion and extension of the elbow. Finally, in level 3, the patient must capture 5 pieces of meat while fleeing from predators. This level works on motor and visuospatial coordination, as well as on proprioception and reaction speed. The system also includes a control panel, where the therapist can register, change and consult patient data, configure the general parameters of the virtual environment, select the levels in each session, and configure the challenges for each one of them. So, it is possible to create a customized execution protocol, configuring the sessions according to the therapeutic needs of each patient. In this protocol, the difficulty is gradually increased by the therapist, without discouraging the patient. Therefore, as the participant evolves, completing the challenges more easily, the therapist modifies the parameters of each level for the next executions, consequently, adjusting the rehabilitation procedures according to the clinical evolution. The modification of each parameter is correlated with the level of difficulty defined by the therapist, which directly depends on the patient's condition. For the control interface, a prototype of a robotic platform for assisted support was built. This device is easy to configure, allows movements and different degrees of freedom, and requires minimal therapist supervision, in addition to being able to assess motor performance and configure the dosage of assistance or resistance to movement. The platform has a mechanism composed of 2 motors driven by cables that act in a Cartesian plane. The patient performs the movements using a rod fixed to a rail connected to the cables, which activates the motors, providing assistance feedback. The therapist can configure this assistance to generate elastic force in the patient's arm, helping him or her in the execution of the movement, or restrict the movements to require greater muscle activation. The virtual environment was integrated to the force platform using the developed communication interface, where the manipulator's movement in the X and Y axes is reflected in the harpy's movements. The biomechanical model was developed using OpenSim software and includes 38 muscles that were considered important for the analysis. Thus, it is possible to perform several analyses of strength and movement, and identify the performance of each muscle during the training execution. Learning inappropriate and harmful compensatory movements for their complete rehabilitation can be avoided. The use of an integrated system can be very helpful to the neurological rehabilitation process, especially when supported by highly adjustable environments that respect individual limitations. This will provide the physiotherapist with tools for analyzing the evolution and treatment outcomes. The robotic device and the virtual environment, supplied by a complete musculoskeletal model that responds according to the movement tracking of the affected limb, can provide important responses associated with the compensation of movements that affect the rehabilitation process. So, it is possible to have a good evaluation of the affected upper limb when compared to the healthy one. Therefore, the goal is to use this system as a method of future rehabilitation, since both the robotic device and the virtual environment offer a more efficient practice of exercises upon more engaged individuals. The clinical application of the described protocol will be performed in the post-stroke sensorimeter rehabilitation process, and its effectiveness compared with conventional physical therapy.